punitive damages. We don't have those just yet. Bob, thank you. Mark?
All righty. That's our first hour of Morning Call. I'm Mark Haynes. Be sure to watch Squawk on the Street tomorrow, 9 a.m. Eastern Time. And Liz, I'll see you tomorrow at 10.
Okay, Mark. And for those of you watching in Europe, the closing bell is next. The second hour of Morning Call starts right now. Welcome to Morning Call. I'm Liz Klayman.
And I'm Michelle Caruso Cabrera. Retirement savings plans about to get a major overhaul. President Bush will sign the new Pension Protection Act into law in just a few hours. The legislation is expected to boost participation in 401k plans by making it easier to enroll automatically. CNBC's Sharon Epperson is here. And Sharon, how is the average person going to be affected by this?
Well, you know, Michelle, the average person has had to deal with a lot of changes in retirement benefits for a while. Companies have been converting traditional defined benefit pensions, which give retirees a set amount of money every month for life, to
days of solid gains on the markets. Today, we're adding to those gains. You know, after a couple of days, the Dow and the S&P have hit three-month highs. Hewlett-Packard is today boosting the blue chips. Dow Jones Industrials up about 14.5 points to 11,341. The NASDAQ at a one-month high, up 7 points at the heights of the session to 2156. Let's see how much higher that can go. S&P 500 showing a gain of about half a point to 1296. Let's get right to the New York Stock Exchange. Bob Pisani's on the trading floor. Bob, I was trying to think today, these gains on any other day might look pretty good, but after the past couple of days, they look sort of just like a little candy sprinkle on top of the big sundae.
Yeah, it's a bit of a flat day. Advanced declinings are about equal. The volume a tad stronger than yesterday. We did 1.6 billion yesterday. And if you want to complain, that was the one complaint on the floor. There wasn't as much buying interest as you'd like to see. Remember, the traders down here, you have to get people enthusiastic about buying. And when stocks are up, they look to the volume to see whether there are a lot of people in the market while stocks were moving up. It was just an average day yesterday. It'll probably be that today. We'll do about 1.6 billion shares here today. The key thing is about the change in sentiment. And Liz, Mark and I were talking about this. If you look how we're doing so far on the week, the transports up 6.5%. All stocks that are economically sensitive, like cyclical stocks, have been doing very well, led by the transports. Industrials have been doing well on top of that. Even the retailers have turned around. Some of the companies have had very mediocre retail reports, like today with Barnes & Noble. Sales down 1%. Earnings okay on some cost-saving measures a couple of months ago. They would have sold that off. Today, the stock is up rather nicely. The consumer maybe won't be as weak as some people thought here. Let's talk about some stocks that are moving. Here's Merck, the post for Merck. Not terribly active, but you heard earlier, about an hour ago, we got some news that they lost a Vioxx suit, a retired FBI agent who had suffered a heart attack after taking Vioxx, was entitled, according to the jury, to $50 million. This is compensatory damage. And from Merck, saying that Merck was negligent for failing to adequately warn the man about his risks. And of course, these are compensatory, not punitive damages. Right now, by one count, Merck has now won 5 cases and lost 4 cases. Merck down a little bit on that. And Hewlett-Packard, which is right around the corner, we're at a 5-year high, folks, right now. They announced a big buyback. The earnings and sales were strong. What I think is important here is that, in general, the tech commentary in the first part of this quarter was pretty poor. Remember, the outlook was not very good for most of them. Hewlett's numbers were particularly good here. And again, you put a little bit of positive comments from Hewlett on top of a change in sentiment, and you get much more positive momentum in the techs. Liz, excuse me, Michelle, back to you.
And speaking of positive momentum, Bob, just like we had in stocks for the last 2 days, Treasury's put in a nice couple of days of gains. How are they doing today? Still stronger across the board again. 2-year yielding 4.88 and the 10-year at 4.85. Remember, before the PPI came out, that number was at 5%. As for the dollar, suffering 2 days of losses on the back of that data, add to it now, day 3 for the dollar getting weaker against the yen, the euro, and the, oh no, slightly stronger against the pound, just moving there. 115.5 yen for every dollar. Euro will cost you $1.28. Moving on now to gold, it's lower by $4.50, 0.7%, $634.50 per ounce.
Oil falling for the fourth consecutive session as supply concerns ease. Looking at crude oil for the moment, we've seen a pullback over the past couple of days, down $1.09 or 1.5% to $70.75 a barrel. Will we get below that? Well, in addition, the Mideast ceasefire, some would call it just a ceasing of hostilities for the moment, that has held. The summer driving season is winding down. We're going to discuss how you can get around it.
But first, how to avoid long security lines at airports, becoming a registered traveler. Isn't that a good idea, Philippeau?
It is, Michelle, because down here in Orlando, the first airport to put in a registered traveler program, forget about waiting, and actually there's not as many people waiting now to go through the regular security checks. The key might be right here in this little card. We'll explain when Morning Call returns.
You're watching Morning Call on CNBC, first in business worldwide.
The world is getting